Hello, it's Patrick here from the GarageBandGuide.com. Love it or loathe it, autotune or pitch correction is everywhere in music right now. And in this video, I'm going to show you how you can use it in GarageBand. While it's sometimes used as a creative tool in itself, dialed up to 11 to create a robotic warbling sound ubiquitous with artists like T-Pain, will.i.am and Daft Punk, pitch correction is just as useful as a way to smooth over some cracks in an otherwise solid vocal performance. It's become so widely used in modern music production that it's best to look at it as just another production tool like reverb, echo, distortion, or compression. In GarageBand, pitch correction exists as a simple and straightforward plugin that you can add to your audio tracks. With your audio track selected, open the editor window and you'll see the pitch correction slider on the left. If you don't see the slider, make sure you have the track tab selected, not the region tab. The number on the right of the pitch correction slider is a simple 0 to 100 retune strength level. Now just drag the pitch correction slider to the right to increase the amount of tuning adjustment, or drag it to the left to decrease the amount of adjustment.
So come on, move your body. Your body close to mine. So come on, move your body. Your body close to mine. I know you need somebody. Nobody could be right. So come on, move your body. Your body close to mine. I know you need somebody. Nobody could be right.
By default, GarageBand adjusts notes to the closest note on the chromatic scale, but you can restrict pitch correction to notes in the key of your project by checking the Limit to Key checkbox. You can change the key of your project in the LCD at the top of the GarageBand window.
So come on, move your body. Your body close to mine. I know you need somebody. Nobody could be right. So come on, move your body. Your body close to mine. I know you need somebody, nobody could be right.
Well, there you have it. That about covers how to use pitch correction in GarageBand on Mac. If you found this video helpful, then hit the like button. I really do appreciate it. And it lets me know that you want to see more videos just like this one. Subscribe if you haven't already, and don't forget to hit the bell icon there to make sure you don't miss a thing. I've been Patrick from thegarageBandguide.com, and I'll see you next time. Bye for now.